So the Nokia 6.1 is the first phone to have a notch display. It's the second phone from Nokia to have a glass back. The first one was Nokia Sirocco. And it's also the third phone in the Nokia 6 series. But will it be your next Android phone? You're watching India Today Tech. I'm Rahul Sethi, and this is our review of the Nokia 6.1 Plus. Like every other phone, the Nokia 6.1 Plus has its upsides and some downsides. There are good features and there are some bad features, and there are some things missing on the Nokia 6.1 Plus. Topping the list of good things is the display on Nokia 6.1 Plus. It has a notch at the top, but what's more important is that the display is quite bright and very punchy. You get a full HD panel which has a 5.8 inch size, which is not very big but not small either. Coupled to a very smooth touchscreen, the Nokia 6.1 Plus gives you a very nice Android experience. The notch size is small and looks quite in proportion with the overall screen and the size of the phone, and the software is also optimized for proper viewing. And in the home screen, you'll see icons take the respective spaces beside the notch to utilize that area. Next, taking further this notch design, it's the premium look of the phone. You get a glass back and a metal frame to top it off. The black color variant we received for review looks quite nice. At 16,000 rupees, it's quite a premium phone to have, and also an ergonomic one. As I said, the display is not very big, but not small either, so you get a very good one-hand grip, and this overcomes the slippery nature of this glass phone. Sides and corners are curved to give you a very comfortable hold, and there are all the regular ports you expect on a phone at this price. The fingerprint scanner, as we have mentioned in our previous videos as well, doesn't have the best placement. If you have long hands, using the fingerprint scanner would require some getting used to. Next, the Nokia 6.1 Plus is not only good outside, but it's also powerful inside. There's a Snapdragon 636 chip with 4GB of RAM and 64GB of storage. Surely this is not as powerful as what you get on the Mi A2 or what you get on the Poco F1. But as we said in our comparison video as well, that if you're not very much into gaming and want a phone for regular use, the Snapdragon 636 based phone would be a much better choice, because at 1.8 GHz, it runs much cooler and doesn't really heat up. In fact, gaming is not really an issue on Nokia 6.1 Plus. It handles games like Asphalt 9 or PUBG quite well. You could experience freezes, but that would be very rare. In our months-long use, I think we experienced it once or twice, not more than that. And I think the stock Android interface has a more important role to play. It's not only more optimized, but streamlined, and you get a very good battery backup as well. But surely you would want to ask, is this phone as fast as the likes of Honor Play, the Mi A2, or even the Poco F1? And the answer is no. It's not as fast as those phones, because no matter how optimized the interface is, the Snapdragon 636 won't be as fast as a Snapdragon 845 processor, for example. But being fastest is not what the Nokia 6.1 Plus is pitching for. What it's pitching for is a smoother interface that can get the job done, runs cool, and also gives you a premium look and feel in a lesser price tag. Now, last but very important thing that Nokia has done with the Nokia 6.1 Plus is give it fast charging. You do get a Type-C USB port, but it's also supplied with a fast charger that charges up the phone from 0 to 100 within 100 minutes. It's not the fastest out there, of course, but it's pretty fast. Though the battery on Nokia 6.1 Plus is not very big, but it will still be able to give you a good one-day use, if you're not using it very extensively, that is. In my daily usage, which requires 24/7 internet connectivity, use of social media apps, an hour or two of gaming, frequent camera usage, and texting, I was easily able to save about 10% of charge by the end of the day. So that were all the good things about the Nokia 6.1 Plus. Now, what's not that great on it is the cameras. The 6.1 Plus comes with dual camera setup at the back, and the photos taken by the camera are not as amazing as what you get on other phones in similar price bracket, especially if you compare it with the Xiaomi phones, the Mi A2 or the Redmi Note 5 Pro. In fact, it's not as good as its predecessor, which had Zeiss lenses. The Nokia 6.1 Plus skips that and uses regular lenses. Although in daylight you'll see that doesn't really affect the performance much. You get decent shots with nice color reproduction, doable dynamic range, and overall sharpness. But in low light photos, you'll recognize the sharpness is not as good as that of a Nokia 6.1. The portrait shots are also not as amazing as that of the Mi A2, but they're decent if you compare it with other phones that use a similar depth sensor for capturing depth data. The video recording capabilities of the cameras are quite nice. You can record them in up to 4K resolution, but if you talk about the shake reduction, it's not as comparable as other phones. It has EIS, that is electronic image stabilization, but it doesn't work wonders and won't make a perfect shake-free video. The front camera is in a better position though. It's a 16 megapixel sensor, so you get good resolution. The details are also quite nice, and in low light as well, you get good color reproduction. But again, not as good as what you get on the Mi A2, which has a 20 megapixel sensor and captures slightly sharper photos. Now for the second drawback, let's come back to the design of the phone. I did say the phone has premium look and feel, and that is because of the glass back. But this design is not what Nokia is known for. Nokia is known for making very strong and sturdy smartphones, and the two previous Nokia 6 series phones were a proof of that. So the Nokia 6.1 Plus may be surely small, light, ergonomic, and even good looking, but it's not as sturdy as other Nokia phones that had full metal unibody designs, or full metal unibody designs from other companies for that matter. So you run the risk of shattering the glass back while you're carrying the Nokia 6.1 Plus with you, and that is true with most glass back phones. There is no waterproofing and there is no wireless charging as well. In fact, Nokia didn't even put NFC on the phone, which is quite a basic feature and you'd find in many under 15,000 rupee phones. Also, the physical keys at the side don't have a very tactile feedback, and you don't get a dual speaker setup on the Nokia 6.1 Plus either. So by now you probably know what the Nokia 6.1 Plus is good at and where it fails to shine. But still, to put all this into one perspective, here is what the Nokia 6.1 Plus is all about. The 6.1 Plus sticks majority of the things right. It has a premium design, good software with guarantee of upgrades for 2 years, good battery backup, fast charging, expandable storage, and a nice display to top it off. But the cameras on the phone are average at best. The build is not as strong as what you expect of Nokia phone, but it's decent nonetheless. And there are some missing features like a set of dual speakers or NFC. Do let us know if Nokia 6.1 Plus is your next phone or you're planning to buy some other one in the comment section below. Also, if you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and share it with your friends. Subscribe to our channel to get latest videos on gadgets like this. Thank you for watching.